You might think all the people on this beach are just working on their suntans. But beneath all that sunscreen, under the skin, there's a frenzy of activity. Without even thinking about it, almost all the adults here are busy trying to reproduce. They can't help themselves. The urge to procreate is a fundamental part of life. Not just for us, but for all life. Why is this urge so universal? At least some blame can probably go to this. DNA, the molecule that carries our genes, the chemical instructions for building our bodies and keeping us alive, all wrapped up in a tiny winding staircase. DNA has run the show for more than 4 billion years for one main reason. It's very good at making copies of itself. The copies can get passed to a new generation in a couple of ways. If you're a bacterium, you might be into cloning, making exact replicas of yourself. All your descendants have the same DNA and, except for an occasional mutant, are just like you. It's simple, it works. And genetically, it's extremely boring. It can also be dangerous. If humans were all clones, everyone would have the exact same immune system, and one successful parasite could wipe us all out. Fortunately, there's sex. The method of choice for 99.9% of the organisms on Earth, more complex than bacteria. With sexual reproduction, two individuals each provide some DNA. Most animals put it into sperm or eggs. If the two can get together, a new being will be created, one that's different from its parents and everybody else. Where there's sex, there's variety. And when it comes to survival of the fittest, variety has a definite advantage. All this comes at a price. Sexual reproduction may be popular, but it's also quite tricky. To get an idea of how tricky, just take a peek inside a man's testicle. It's packed with tiny tubes coiled into bundles. Stretched out, they could cover half a mile. Inside all this tubing, the average man is churning out 1,000 new sperm every second. That's about 100 million new sperm every day, and more than 2 trillion over a lifetime. And here's the tricky part. Each and every sperm is one of a kind, carrying a unique genetic package. How is this possible? How can one person produce so many different combinations of genes? The answer lies in the very special way we make sperm and eggs, a process called meiosis. In almost every cell of your body, you have 30,000 or more different genes, spread out on very long strands of DNA called chromosomes. Most cells have two versions of every gene on a total of 46 chromosomes. Exactly half of those, 23, came from your mom. And 23 came from your dad. They come in pairs, where the partners are very similar but not quite the same. The only time they get together is during meiosis. Here's how it works inside a testicle that's making sperm. First, each chromosome makes an exact copy of itself, keeping it attached at one point. They condense, creating an X shape. Now the chromosome partners get together, and the two, or actually four, will embrace. They cling so closely, big chunks carrying whole bunches of genes get exchanged between the partners. The cell then divides twice, each time pulling the pairs apart. The final result is a sperm, or an egg cell, with 23 chromosomes, half the normal number. By itself, the cell is incomplete, but it still holds incredible promise, because every chromosome now carries a combination of genes that has never existed before. All this gene shuffling means that within a single species, there can be an enormous amount of diversity. And the more diversity, the better the odds are that someone will survive to create a new generation.